Hello students, so in the last lecture we see the theory of floating foundation, the different types of soil 1, soil 2, right, contact pressures on the sand, right, and bearing capacity of hoses methods, highway pavement, which is a flexible and rigid payments, right, the difference of flexible payment and rigid payment, factory, the factors which are affecting the selection of payment design, right? And what are the factors to be considered while designing the payment, right? Group index methods, right? So last topic we see that the factors which are considered, right? So design below subgrade soil, it's a design life, climate factors, payment component materials, environmental factors, drainage conditions, road geometry, right? So here, what are the flexible payment design methods? So starting with the first one is a group index method, which is also known as a GI method, then CBR method. Next is a California R value or a stabilometer method. Next is a triaxial test method. Next is a Burmeister method, and last one is a McClure method, right? So talking about the group index method, group index is an arbitrary index given to the type of soil, and it is generally based on the percentage of fines, liquid limit, and the plastic limit, plasticity index, right? So the GI index equation is GI is equal to 0.2A plus 0.005AC plus 0.01BD. Right, here A is equal to F minus 35, which is maximum of 40, B is equal to F minus 15, C is equal to WS minus 40, D is equal to IP minus 10, F is equal to percentage by mass passing through a 0.75 mm sieve, WL is equal to liquid limit, IP is equal to plasticity index. Right, so the higher the value of group index, the poorer is the quality of the soil, right? So basically, it is used for fine-grained soils for their suitability as a highway materials. So the range of GI value, right, different for the different purposes, right? So the volume of daily traffic is divided into five categories, right? First one is a very light category. Here, less than 50 vehicles per day. Then the volume of daily traffic is light. Right, so the vehicle is considered as 50 to 250 vehicles per day. When 250 to 500 vehicles per day considered as a minimum medium daily traffic, 500 to 750 vehicles per day it considered as a heavy day, heavy traffic, and the 750 to 1000 vehicles per day considered as a very heavy volume of traffic, right? So depending upon the GI grading of soil, the daily volume of traffic, thickness of the surface course, base course, and the subbase are determined from the following the chart. Right, so here chart indicates that the type of subgrade, which is excellent, good, fair, and poor. Here GI index also given in 0 to 1, 2 to 4, 5 to 9, and 10 to 20, right? Here daily volume of traffic, vehicles per day also given, very light, medium, heavy, and very very heavy, right? Here subways are given, right? So this basically a design chart for a GI method. So there are some points should be noted. So the first one is the thickness of subbase depends on the GI grading of soil. The thickness of surface and base depends on the volume of traffic, minimum of 10 centimeter thickness being provided for the base. Method as such is essentially an empirical method based on physical properties of the subgrade soil, and it does not consider the strength characteristics of subgrade soil, right? So next is CBR method. So GI method does not take into consideration the characteristics of the payment material forming the various courses of payment. So IRC has recommended that the CBR method for the design of flexible payment. The CBR method not only consider the characteristics of the subgrade soil, but also taken into consideration the properties of materials forming the various courses of the payment. So here, the following figure shows the CBR design chart. So table number 2.5 shows seven curves, which is A to G, A, B, C, D to G letter, and corresponding the traffic units. So approximate curve is selected based on the number of commercial vehicles per day exceeding 3 tons laden weight from the table number 2.5. So from the figure, the total thickness of the flexible pavement needed to cover the subgrade of the known CBR value is then obtained. So in case there is a material superior than the soil subgrade, such that it may be used as a sub-base course, then the thickness of the construction over this material could be obtained from the design chart, knowing the CBR value of the sub-base. So the thickness of the sub-base course is the total thickness minus the thickness over the sub-base. So when the CBR value of soil upgrade is less than 12%, the total thickness of pavement may be calculated by the expression given by US crops of engineers given below. So the equation T is equal to under root P in bracket 1.75 divided by CBR minus 1 divided by PR whole raised to 1/2. Right, here T is equal to pavement thickness, which is unit in centimeter. P is equal to wheel load, unit is in kg. P is equal to type pressure, unit is kg per semi square. Right, so here this traffic classification table given. So depending upon the curves, there are different number of commercial vehicle per day, right? So for A curve, it's between 0 to 15, for B 15 to 45, for C 45 to 150, for D 150 to 450, for E 450 to 1500, and for F is equal to 1500 to 4500, and for the G it's more than 4500, right? So for IRC recommendation, some of the important points recommended by this IRC and CBR method, right? So first is CBR test should be performed on the remolded soils in the laboratory. In situ tests are not recommended for the design purpose. The specimen should be prepared by the static compaction whenever is possible, and otherwise by dynamic compaction. For the design of the new roads, subgrade soil sample should be compacted at OMC to proctor density whenever suitable compaction equipment is available to achieve this density in the field. Otherwise, the soil sample may be compacted to the dry density expected to be achieved in the field. In case of existing roads, the sample should be compacted to field density of the subgrade soil. In new construction, the CBR test samples may be soaked in water for 4 days period before testing. However, in areas with arid climate or when the annual rainfall is less than 50 centimeters and the water table is too deep and affect the soil, the subgrade adversely, it is not necessary to soak the soil specimen before the carrying out the CBR test. At least 3 samples should be taken on each type of soil at the same density and the moisture content. If the maximum variation in CBR values of 3 specimens exceed the specified limits, the design CBR should be average of at least 6 samples, right? So the top 50 centimeter of subgrade should be compacted at least up to 95 to 100% of proctor density. When the subbase course contains substantial proportion of aggregates of size above 20 centimeter, the CBI value of this material would not be valid for the design of subsequent layers above them. Right? And design traffic can be estimated by the following formula, which is A is equal to P in bracket 1 plus R raised to N plus 10. Here, N is equal to number of years between the last count and the years of completion of the construction. A is equal to number of vehicles per day for design. P is equal to number of heavy vehicles per day, at least a count, and R is equal to annual rate of increase of heavy vehicles. Right, so here CBR methods, right, which is million standard axle, right? So for IRC full form is Indian Road Congress, has revised the guideline for the design of flexible pavement based on the concrete of cumulative standard axle loads rather than the total number of all commercial vehicles. So in case road with a design traffic more than 1500 commercials vehicles per day, the design traffic is defined in terms of cumulative number of standard axle loads of 8160 kg carried during the design life of the road. So the mixed commercial vehicles with the different axle loads are to be converted in the terms of cumulative number of standard axle load NS to cater for the design, right? So the relation is NS is equal to 365A in bracket 1 plus R is to N minus 1 divided by R multiplied by F. Here E is equal to number of commercial vehicles per day, R is equal to annual growth rate of commercial vehicles, N is equal to design life of payment, F is equal to vehicle damage factor equivalent to number of standard axle for commercial vehicles on the road stretch. Right, so the total thickness required is determined using this chart. Right, so for the design of rigid pavement, there are some general considerations. Cement concrete pavement represent the group of rigid pavements. The load carrying capacity of cement concrete pavement is mainly due to the rigidity and high modulus of elasticity of the slab. So modulus of subgrade reaction. Westergaard considered the rigid pavement slab at the thin elastic plate resting on. Okay, so